Okay, so we had a terrible winter, and wouldn't you know it, it goes from 39 degrees. The very next day, it jumps right up to the high 50s and low 60s. And look at this beehive. This hive looked like it wasn't doing anything at all, but you know what? There's an abundance of bees inside, and the brood was hatching, and the numbers are up. And the next thing you know, right out of the blue, beekeepers are going to be caught off guard right and left, and their bees are going to swarm. And when you see the behavior of this colony, it is bustling. And what could happen at any moment is they'll zip out of there and they'll be replacing a queen. So this is a time of year to be looking for queen cells and to look for a population explosion in your colonies coming out of winter. And look at this right here. This is called a swarm trooper. This is a swarm trap. Now these are new this year for me. I'm trying them out. I've put a few together and I'm going to put one together for you today in this video. We're going to go step by step. They came up with the dimensions of this based on Cornell's Department of Ornithology. I don't know if you've read the book, The Honeybee Democracy, but they did a lot of testing on what bees are looking for when it comes to a swarm trap. And it deals a lot with the physical dimensional interior space. And the swarm trooper copies that exactly. So it seems like a pretty good deal. I mean, if you're hauling wooden boxes up and putting them along the tree line, normally about 12 feet up, then they can be pretty heavy. So this thing is a relief, as lightweight as it is. This is just a sign marking the perimeters of my bee yard, my backyard apiary here in the state of Pennsylvania, northeastern United States. And the swarm troopers I purchased from the Blythewood Bee Company, blythewoodbeecompany.com. You can also get them off of Amazon. And step by step here, it comes with this painter's tape, these blue pieces, and you want to leave those because we're going to use them later. It also comes with Swarm Commander Premium Swarm Lures. You get three doses in there. Each one's good for a little over a week, so once you're in prime swarm season and you put that box out and you're going to trap that swarm, you want to put a little of that on there. It comes with two straps, and this is also how the box is held together and then suspended in a tree, the way I showed you earlier. So I'm going to walk you through step by step. These are the instructions that come with it. It shows you that we're going to put together the top, and it comes from Miller's Manufacturing, Anderson, South Carolina. Beetlejail is the email address at gmail.com, and you even get a sticker here, Swarm Trooper. Obvious tie-in there to Star Wars. Anyway, these are the components. It is mostly cardboard, and the exterior is that type of corrugated material that's normally used for campaign signs and things like that, so it is weatherproof. This is much more durable than I originally thought it would be. And again, things are clearly marked. See how this is identified as for the inside. It also has vents built into it, screens, so that when you do have a swarm in there and you're going to transport this thing, you can open the vents up on the sides, close up the entrance at the bottom, and then you've got a transport kit too. So this thing is pretty handy overall. I have a number of them, but I thought it would be worthwhile to show you how to put it together so that you can have some of these on your shelf and ready to go. This spring, it inevitably happens that people get caught off guard and swarms take off. If you've got a neighboring beekeeper, you want to get some free bees. Swarm Trooper assembly instructions right here. Now this is the tape. It's just painter's tape that comes with it, and you can use this to hold the pieces together while you assemble it. These are the interior components, two frame rests, top cover, and it also has a hole for a feeder. The feeder does not come with it, but it has the space. And we're going to start with the cover, and it's marked here inside. This is all made in the United States of America. And don't pop out that hole, because if you don't have a feeder, I think that's for people that are going to leave bees in this long term. I'm not. Whenever the bees inhabit it, I'm going to take it down and rehive them. So this is a temporary enclosure. Now what I'm doing, this is the top for the box, and we're going to pre-bend everything, get it kind of flexing here so that it squares up nice and easy when it comes time to assemble it, and I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm just going to bend it around, and again, it looks flimsy, it looks like cardboard, but it is much more durable than that. And we'll get into that. As you already saw in the video, I have them out in the trees now. So this is just another one. I decided to make this quick tutorial for those of you who have never seen one of these, and I will show you how to put it together. And so that's it. You just, the little tabs go in the corners there, and it's squared up and ready to go. There's a cardboard insert that also has a cutout for the feeder. And we just pop that in right here. And again, I didn't see any information about this feeder that would go with it. But if you're going to use this kind of like a temporary housing for your bees, and you're going to leave them in here for a while, you're going to want to feed them, and you're going to open the vents and things like that. But for me, these are temporary. This is just to trap a swarm, and then put that right into the apiary. And you have to push these vent openings from the inside. I was able to catch them here with my fingernail and pull them out, because if you don't pop them out ahead of time, once the screens are in place, you can't push through the screens. You might damage that. So push them out now and get them ready. And of course, here's the main entrance to the swarm trooper here. And it just popped that out because that is going to be open when we put this thing up in a tree somewhere. And this is a close-up of the vent enclosure. Again, we're going to push that shut just a little bit. You'll be able to catch the edge with your fingernail if you need to open it at another time. But that is just venting. And then here, of course, the main entrance. So their entrance dimensions, the interior dimensions, as I mentioned before, everything was based on the research that was done. And when they arrived at those parameters, from the author of the Honeybee Democracy there. So this is going to be curious to me. Now, again, I haven't proven this. I haven't tested it. I've never caught a swarm in one. I'm just going to put this together and show you how to do it. And if it works out, I'm going to share, of course, with you how to get the bees out of this and put them in a hive box. So it looks pretty good to me so far. And again, the lightweight of the entire assembly is a huge advantage if you're climbing ladders and things and strapping these up into trees. There's a method of suspending this with a rope and then have stabilizing ropes coming off of it. I'm just anchoring them right to the main trunk of a tree and resting it on a branch. And again, pre-bend these as much as possible because we're going to square it up, and then we're going to run the straps through here to hold it in place. This is where that painter's tape that comes with it comes in handy as a placeholder once you square it up. And these holes in the bottom align, and we're going to run the straps through those. So there it is, pretty straightforward. Now let's feed the strap through here. And I want to align it so that the buckle is coming up the side of the swarm trooper. I don't want it over the top or on the bottom. So we're going to feed this through here, and this is our chance to line things up just right. And again, this is your chance to square it. The tape is just temporary. Once we get the straps in here, we're going to be able to pull that painter's tape right off. And it doesn't do any damage to the swarm trooper exterior. This thing is pretty nice. Again, kind of like those campaign signs that you see in people's yards. It's designed to stand up to the weather for quite a while. So we'll feed it through the bottom here. And to get that going, this can be a little fussy, but you can reach in for the inside. And again, the alignment of that buckle is kind of what's important now at this point. And I thought I might like hot glue a dab onto the buckle to have it hold its place, but I decided not to. It seemed to work okay without that. So here we are, both straps are through. And we'll give you a quick look here on the interior. That's what it looks like inside. And we're going to cover that up with a firm piece of cardboard that's designed to insert and cover that hole too. So there's no venting coming through the bottom, and it's going to be pretty much airtight all over, which is what the bees are going to be looking for. We want to find a space that's going to protect them from the weather. We want to put this in a tree that shelters it midday and get some morning sun. That's always helpful. So if you can face that to the east or to the south a little bit, the entrance-wise, that would be good. And then these are the stiffeners for the walls that go in, and they're marked clearly. There's a little stamp on it that says top there, so you can't mess it up. Pretty straightforward again, and there is a space between the sidewalls here that you'll notice, and then we're going to put the end panels in. The end panels are notched out and they're marked clearly which side faces the inside, and then they're notched out just like a bee box, and we're going to put some frames in there that I'm going to show you in a second. But they just push in, everything is nice. There's an opening on both ends at the bottom, so it doesn't matter which one you put in. One is going to line up with that main entrance to the swarm trooper. And then there's this flexing going on here. I took some hot glue and dribbled it down in there and cinched that right up, no problem. Here it is now, it's all glued up for me. They say you can use tape or something else, but I decided hot glue was immediate and worked really well. So here's just the base unit. All the inserts are in, the bottom, the sides, the end panels, and of course the straps are ready to go. I'm going to give you a close up here of how the strap works. One side is flat in that centerpiece there, and then it's beveled on the other, so we'll feed it through underneath, closes to the buckle, loop it over, feed it back in, and now those teeth are going to grip it nice when you cinch it up, and it's going to hold its place. And of course, it's also a quick clip there, so you can take that off and use this to rope it up to tree branches and things like that. So that's it. It's going to hold it together. Going to keep the box squared, and we can even take the tape off the bottom here in a second. And I'm just going to put the top on, show you how it works. That's it. It's a simple unit. I have several of these. I recommend you get a bunch of them and put them on your shelves and have them ready to go. And I'm putting pre-waxed single piece plastic frames here. I'm going to put three of them in. It has spacing for five. But again, I don't plan to leave the swarm in here for very long. So this just gives them something to hang on to and to start their wax buildup. So let's start drawing this out. And also don't forget your swarm lures. You're going to want to put that in there. A little bit along the backs of these frames, interior of the cover, and a tiny dab at the main entrance. So that's it. It's a swarm trooper. And I'll be sure to update you when we get some swarms in here. But be ready this spring. Your bees can swarm at any time. You're not going to see it coming. Trust me, it happens every year. People get off guard and they start saying, wow, my bees swarmed. I don't even know why. So let's get ready, get some swarm traps out there, and take a look at these swarm troopers. They seem pretty nice. Thanks for watching the video. Keep an eye on your bees. I hope they're super healthy. And I hope you have a great honeybee keeping year. Thanks for watching as always.